Hey, you're Janine, right?
We live across the hall.
Oh, yeah, Orion. Yeah, I noticed. Nice to meet you.
We actually met
before, at Inducted Students Day. Remember we sat down next to each other?
Right. Yes, nice to meet you officially.
This might be a weird question.
Can I borrow your laptop charger?
Sure.
Thanks for the charger, you're a lifesaver.
Don't mention it.
Why do you keep looking up your name on Google?
What?
That's your name, right?
You keep refreshing on Google?
Yeah, I just have to see if anything new pops up.
Are you, like, a celebrity? Or a criminal?
No, not really. I just wrote a poem, and I wanted to make sure that it went up online.
No way! You write poetry? That's dope.
Nah, it's whatever.
No, I love poetry. You should read me one.
No, I don't share it with anybody.
Didn't you just say you posted one online?
I like your shirt.
Aw, thanks. Frogs are kind of my spirit animal.
It's cute. Well, the shirt's cute, not you. I mean, well, you are pretty, but, like, I don't mean that in a weird way.
Thanks.
Is that the right way to say that? I don't want to, like, overstep a boundary. We kind of, like, just met.
No, what you said was fine.
Great. Okay, cool. Well, anyways, I gotta go take a tinkle. But it was nice meeting you.
Officially.
Officially. We should do this again tomorrow. And maybe we can actually hang out.
Yeah.
All right, well, good night and sleep well and all that.
Ryan.
Thank you. Take a tinkle. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Lots of things, bud. Lots of things.
Hi, Constance.
So?
Who is that?
The girl from across the hall. That's just Janine.
I know. Good luck convincing her you're straight after you brought up all your poetry.
You think it's hopeless?
Well, considering you haven't trimmed down that belly of yours and your face is still that weird shape it's always been. Yeah.
It is hopeless.
No, it's not hopeless. I would tell you if it was hopeless. Because who's always right?
You are.
Thanks, bestie.
How do I not fuck this up this time?
This time? You say that as if you've ever actually had a romance in your life.
You gonna help or not?
You can ask me to leave, you know?
I won't.
I know you won't. I'm all you've got.
How do I win Janine over? I need this to work.
Well, that's a lot more confidence than I'm used to coming from you.
Well, I'm 18. It's about time I found someone.
Before it's too late.
Before the truth comes out.
Yep. And once the world finds out what you've done, and we know they will, it's gonna be a lot harder for you to find a date. Speaking of which, have you Googled yourself yet today?
I did. It's just a Facebook post from my mom and a blog post from the poetry club.
Good. Now all you gotta do is act cool and don't talk about any of that to Jean.
How do you suppose I act cool?
Don't worry, Orion. I'm gonna help you!
Okay, just give it to me one more time.
She'll be here any second. Fine. Belly in, shoulders broad, and a smile! Oh God! Oh Jesus
what?
Christ! No, you're...
What?
Your smile is disgusting.
I'm sorry, I'm trying.
Let's just do it one more time, okay? From the top. Belly and shoulders and smile. Great, yes. And then you say...
Hey, what's up?
That'll work.
Really?
Yeah.
Just do exactly what we practiced, okay? Don't forget a thing. She'll be here any second. Good luck.
Hey! You good?
Hey, how's it going?
My parents are getting divorced.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
Oh, I'm totally fucking with you. They've been divorced for years.
I mean, that still sucks.
It's whatever, I gave up on those assholes a long time ago. Anyway, I brought this.
You brought alcohol? I could kiss you.
Here you go.
Maybe I shouldn't.
Oh, no pressure, it's just you seem kind of excited.
Well, I like drinking, but my only real drinking experience was at this Thanksgiving party, and then my aunt gave me a sip of wine, my mom yelled at her, and then she told me, you can't drink, drinking's illegal, if people see you, you'll get arrested, so now I have to make sure that there's no onlookers, or like windows or anything.
Well, it's completely up to you, but if getting in trouble is what you're worried about, then don't. They do not care here. The last time I think someone got in trouble for drinking was like 2009.
So there's no way I'll go to jail.
What? No, you're an 18-year-old having a drink with a friend. You're not going to jail.
I guess one couldn't hurt. And then I told him, what the fuck are you doing?
Did he stop looking?
I mean, he got off the stall, don't worry.
I always think the girls' bathroom is, like, a great place to have a chat, but I just thought guys left guys alone when taking a tinkle.
Wait, do you say take a tinkle too?
Doesn't everyone?
I thought that was just my weird-ass family.
Oh, that reminds me. Well, it's not that funny, but, it's way worse. when I was a junior in high school, my boyfriend at the time forced himself upon me, and that's really not funny.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Did you report it?
I did, but no one believed me.
I feel terrible.
You didn't do anything. You have, like, wholesome small bean energy. You can never be a sex offender. But it's okay. I'm fine. It just, it kind of sucked that it was, like, on my birthday. That made it worse, but
That's terrible.
Well, it's actually, like, my birthday today. All I had to do was watch this Discord watch party of Barnyard, the movie, and I smoked a fuck ton of weed, and it was just a good celebration.
So it's your birthday, like, today, like, you're 19?
Yeah.
Hold on, I can give you something.
Oh my god, no. You do not have to do that.
I picked up a few of these bad boys before school. I have one, and now you have one, and that makes us frog friends.
Oh my god, that's so cute. Thank you.
You know, I've been told I'm a bit of a barnyard fanatic myself. I mean, they always tell me that I can get down harder than any of the animals in that movie, so
prove it.
What? Oh my god, you'll think you're having the time of your life.
Deal with me! Oh my god, loosen up!
Didn't even ask her out?
Well, we held hands.
Really?
Yeah, but I don't think she noticed. She kind of turned around right after.
Well, you gotta do it tonight, next time you see her.
What's the rush?
The rush, pal,
is the friend zone. All right, if you don't make a move on her fast, that's where you're gonna end up.
And maybe I shouldn't have called us frog friends after giving her a ceramic frog then?
I don't even want to know what that means, but no, it probably didn't help. All right, well, as we've learned, Janine gets back from her class at exactly 10:10, which is now, so I'm going to dip. You got this.
Hey, Janine, do you have a minute? I was just wondering, and I know it's only Monday and the weekend is
really far away, but I like to plan ahead, so I was just wondering if you wanted to get dinner or something as maybe a date?
Not to be, like, a dick or anything, but I think I'd prefer if we just stay friends.
Yes, totally. Not a dick.
Yeah, it's just I really value, like, our frog friendship, and, I don't want that to change.
Yeah, please, I don't want things to be, like, weird now.
Oh, don't worry, no.
Okay, good, because I really like being friends.
Great! Well, I'll see you around then.
Fuck you!
What? I tried, okay?
Not hard enough.
She said she wanted to be friends. That's something, right?
That never works.
Yes, it is disappointing, but I really do want to be friends. I mean, I'll get over it.
You are never going to find love. Remember, buddy, the clock's ticking.
Nothing about me has popped up online yet.
You checked today?
Yes.
Good, because we both know it's only a matter of time. You have got to make a miracle with the next pretty girl you see.
Hey, Orion, how's your handwriting?
Terrible.
Good, so is my mom's.
Okay.
Could you do me a favor and sign this permission slip for me?
What for?
We're dissecting frogs in biology, and I can't do that. I've grown too close to my frog. His name's Harold.
That is an excellent name.
Yeah, but my parents won't sign the permission slip, and I can't rip Harold's guts out.
Well, forgery is wrong.
If it's too big a deal for you, you don't have to do it.
But letting poor Harold die is
by far the worst outcome here, so I'll sign it.
Thank you, you're a lifesaver.
And if you're free now, we should totally hang out.
I'd love to, but I should get back to my homework.
Oh.
Oh, it's not about the other day. But let's hang out tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sure. Hey, what's up?
Hey.
I'm Orion. Orion Angelos.
Rose.
What's your last name?
Franco.
Where were you headed?
Nowhere.
Well, you should stay and chat a while, hot stuff.
Okay.
So tell me, Rose Franco, what do you like?
Men. I'm a heterosexual.
Well, that's great, but like, I meant like, what are your interests?
I like my dog, the love of my life, Jesus Christ, going to the beach, iced coffee. Did I say my dog already?
No, not at all. Fascinating stuff.
Thank you.
Do you like poetry?
Ew, what is this, 11th grade English?
Thank God, huge deal breaker for me. Some people just are too obsessed with weird stuff.
I get that. So many people are crazy right now. I had an ex, he had a huge collection of beanbag frogs. It was so fucking weird.
Yikes, I couldn't imagine.
Are you a Jesus man?
Me? Yeah, go to church every Sunday. I come from a big Catholic family, never miss it.
Really? So many people our age give up on Christ the minute they get to college. What'd you think of today's sermon?
You know, I think I was just praying so, so hard that I didn't listen to the gospel.
Oh. Well, what about last week's reading? That one was pretty good too, with the fish and all that.
Yeah, when Jesus multiplies the fishes and the loaves.
No, different story. It's the one where Jesus calls on Peter to be a fisher of men.
Yeah, you know, it's really funny, actually. I think I was just praying so hard to get that one.
Wow, you really are a man of God. That's kind of sexy, if you ask me.
That's so funny, because you're also very sexy, but also very holy and pure.
You're really hot.
Oh my god, goodness. Thank you.
Would you like to hold hands?
I would like to hold hands.
Are you enjoying this?
Yes, I enjoy holding your hand very much.
You're so suave and hand-holdable.
You're also so hand-holdable. So? What are you thinking about?
You.
In what kind of way?
In the mushy-mushy kind of way.
So, maybe would you like to go on a date?
Yes! Oh my god, I would love to.
Taking the Lord's name in vain? I mean, I'm not one to judge, but...
No. When I say God, I say it with a lowercase g, so it doesn't count.
Gotcha.
Well done, Orion. Well done.
You really mean that?
Well, it isn't saying much, but this is pretty much the greatest thing to ever happen in your love life.
Great, I don't feel any less terrified for the first date in my entire life.
Well, you cannot fuck this up.
I know.
Listen, every girl in your entire life has only ever viewed you as a fat cow. But Rose doesn't, and we need to keep it that way.
Right.
Remember, Orion, clock's ticking. Shit, still in there, Orion?
I'm just freshening up. Come on in.
Look at you all dressed up for your big date. You look great.
Thanks, Janine.
What are you guys gonna do?
We're just gonna walk around the mall, get something to eat over there.
You're gonna eat at one of those restaurants? It's a little pricey for a first date.
I told her she could pick wherever she wanted to go. I didn't know she picked the most expensive restaurant in the whole mall, but it's whatever. I really like her.
I'm literally so happy for you. You're gonna have the best time, I just know it.
Thanks, Janine.
Be yourself, loosen up. Remember, you guys have everything in common.
Yup.
And word of advice, no PDA in front of Henry's barber shop. I made that mistake with my ex.
Oh?
He chased us with a broom filled with hair. Would not recommend.
Gotcha.
Well? You better get going, have fun, be safe, and come to my room when you're done. I'm gonna hear every detail when you get back.
Thanks, Shani. I'll see you later.
So, how'd it go?
How'd it go?
Yeah, your date.
I think you mean my girlfriend.
No way! Love that for you! That's so awesome! Wait. Go off, Orion! Provided you got those hickeys in a private spot. Or at least more private than Henry's barbershop.
No, we found like a nice romantic place. I mean, I guess as romantic as the bathroom of the food court can be.
Wow, interesting choice. So tell me about this girlfriend of yours. What's her major? What's she looking to get into?
You know, I don't know.
You guys are exclusive and you didn't think to ask this question?
I asked, but she just sort of went,
mm-hmm. That doesn't answer the question.
Well, I mean, she asked to have her first kiss afterwards, so I didn't think to press further.
Okay. Okay. Well, what's your favorite movie?
You know, that didn't come up either. I mean, I told her about Barnyard, but she just sort of nodded and didn't say anything.
Barnyard is fucking wild. How could she not have anything to say about Cal Kevin James?
Honestly, I think we did more cuddling and kissing than we did talking.
Ryan, are you sure you want to start a relationship just yet? I mean, it just sounds like you don't know a lot about Rose.
Well, why wait? I mean, we have our whole lives to learn about each other, and I'm not interested in dating anyone else, so what's the harm in putting a label on things?
It just sounds like you're putting a lot of faith into someone who you don't know that well.
Why can't you just be happy for me?
I am happy for you.
Just because you don't want to date me doesn't mean someone else won't.
Orion, that's not fair. To either of us.
Damn it. You're right. I'm sorry, Janine.
It's okay.
I didn't mean to.
It's okay.
No, I didn't. I shouldn't have lashed out at you.
Don't worry about it. I am happy for you. I just don't want to see you get hurt.
No, you're right. I should really want to get to know her on a more emotional level next date.
Sounds like a good mindset to have.
Do you have any advice?
Maybe try to learn more about her interests and include her in your interests. You should show her a poem.
She won't like that.
How do you know that?
Just trust me. I do.
Well, try it. And if she hates your work, then it probably wasn't meant to be.
You're right. Next time, I'll try to slow things down and really get to know her.
I love it when you kiss me like that.
Like this.
So, what do you want to do?
We do have the whole room to ourselves.
Yeah?
Why don't we talk?
Okay. What do you want to talk about?
Deep shit, I guess. Have a heart-to-heart.
Okay.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah?
Do you ever think about your soul?
What?
Like, you know, what your soul looks like.
I don't know. Come here.
Can I?
Yeah, do it.
Not that I don't want to, but isn't this, like, a sin?
No penetration. Doesn't count.
I definitely want to do this, but I thought I could read you something first.
Oh?
A poem. I wrote it for you.
I thought you said you didn't like poems.
Well, the romantic kind. Those are neat. Darting through the dimly lit water, thousands of them wander, with intention only they know. Many faces watch through grimy glass, but the fish could not care in the slightest, too happy mingling with each other. Bubbles filter in, rupturing the water, pushing the fish in the most random of ways, chaotic rambles of fate. A fish of luminous gills crashes into another, a chance encounter with a result none of us can know, a moment in time that feels like a thousand. Pulling back from the grimy glass, I look at my love with the utmost content, with the zeal of a thousand hearts. With hair of chocolate and eyes of prophecy, the fish fade into oblivion as I see her and feel her paradisical lips. A goldfish in a bowl stays its size as a free goldfish grows bigger than it was. A man grows in rapture. The wise say there are plenty of fish, an aphorism heard all my days in journeys taken to finally find one.
Nice.
Yeah?
Yeah. It was good.
Is there anything you liked or didn't like particularly?
No. It was just good.
Okay.
What do you want me to say?
Nothing.
It was great. It was fantastic. Is that what you're looking to hear?
I just thought we could talk about the poem.
Okay, well, what do you want to talk about it?
I don't know.
Well, I don't...
Baby, are you mad at me?
No, of course not.
Good, because I never want us to be mad at each other, ever.
Let's never, ever fight.
Let's just keep cuddling and everything will be as amazing and perfect as it is right now. Let's hang out tomorrow.
I'd love to. But didn't you mention that you had plans with your friend Janine?
I did, but what can I say? You're more important.
Oh, baby. It means so much to hear you say that. You're my everything.
What do you want to do tomorrow? You're the lady, so I'll let you pick.
Same as today. Today was perfect.
Of course.
Hey, Janine.
Hey, Orion. I only have a minute or two right now, but I can't wait to catch up later.
About that.
I've seen Rose tonight, and I was hoping we could reschedule again.
You've been doing a lot of rescheduling lately.
I know, and I'm sorry, but I just had to spend enough time with her to make sure that I was ready for tonight.
What's tonight?
I'm gonna tell Rose that I'm in love with her.
Oh, God.
What?
It's a little soon, isn't it?
It's time. I know it.
As long as you're sure.
I mean, I basically already said it in the poem that I wrote for her.
You shared your poetry. Did she like it?
She said she did.
If you think you're ready to say that to her, then who am I to stand in your way?
So, how was your day?
Good.
What did you do?
Texted you.
Right.
What did you do?
Went to class with you. And texted you.
Yeah. What did you do after?
Texted you again. Rose, my beautiful flower, there's something I want to ask you.
Yeah, what is it?
Well, I want to, but I don't know if I should.
Okay, then you don't have to tell me.
What would I want to tell you?
Well, then just tell me.
I think I love you.
I love you too.
I was so scared to tell you.
I know you were, but I knew what you were gonna say.
Would you have been prepared to tell me anyway?
I've loved you since the moment we first called hands a week and a half ago.
And it's our 2-week anniversary.
You should get us a cake or something to celebrate.
I think I made plans with my friend Janine on our 2-week anniversary.
Babe, you forgot our 2-week anniversary.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. I guess we can celebrate another day.
No. Our 2-week anniversary is our special day. I'll just tell Janine that we can hang out another night. Guess who finally found love?
Oh, that's great! Did you Google yourself yet today?
Did you even hear me?
Yes! And I'm asking you if you've Googled yourself yet today.
Why can't you just be happy for me?
No, not while your history is still lingering in cyberspace.
You told me that once I found someone who loved me, who I could fall back on when things got bad with my history. Huh. Well, Rose and I really love each other, and she'd stick with me if she knew my past.
But it's not enough, is it?
You said it would be enough!
I said what you wanted to hear! I tell you what you tell yourself because I am you, Orion. I'm not real.
Then why? Why won't you leave me the fuck alone?
We both know why. Sure, I'm just a figment of your imagination, but you can't live without me. I am the guilt that you feel every day for what you did. Hell, I look just like her. I am the fear that keeps you safe. I am every voice inside your head.
Shut up, I don't want this.
Well, you invited me to talk.
Then leave me alone. Get out of my head. Listen to me.
No, you listen to me. You are going to Google yourself right now. Do it. Do it. What did you see?
I saw...
Speak up, bitch!
I saw
a penis in the search results.
Whose penis?
Mine. From years and years ago. The sick fuck who used an innocent girl who tricked me into sending those photos finally posted them online.
And who told you that would happen?
You. You did.
I told you every day that it was only a matter of time before that trafficker shared your photos. And your whole family, everyone you care about, is going to resent you. We agreed what you have to do now.
No. No, I don't want to.
No. We agreed that there was no way you could bounce back from this. You know what you've got to do.
I changed my mind. I don't want to go, please.
No, you promised. You promised. If you stay alive, there will be consequences.
No, please, I don't want
to. I'm giving you to the count of three, and then I'm doing it for you.
Constance, no.
One. Two.
No, please.
Three.
No.
Now give me the other one.
Fuck, leave me
give
alone.
Give it to me.
Fine, I'll do it myself.
Come on, pussy, at that rate you'll never get it done.
I'm trying, okay?
What the hell do you think you're doing?
What I should have done a long time ago.
You think you can hurt me? You think you can harm me the way I harm you? I'm in your head!
But I'm stronger than you.
What was that?
I am stronger than you.
Don't turn your back on me.
Orion, if you walk out that door, I swear I will—
What? You'll do what? Tell me what you'll do.
Orion! Don't go.
Thanks for letting me come in.
No, not at all. I was just calling my aunt.
I've never called an aunt on a random night.
Not really a relative, more like a family friend.
Right. Sorry, I forgot your family situation.
No, don't be sorry. Just because I don't like my family doesn't mean that I don't have people I love. Come in. How are you?
Not great.
What's up?
I don't want to be a burden.
You're not. If you feel comfortable, you can tell me anything.
You're not my girlfriend. It's not your job to make me happy.
And it's Rose's job to do that?
What are you trying to imply?
I'm just saying, dating her shouldn't be some magical fix for all your problems. No one should be that. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't force it to drink.
But you don't believe in the power of love?
We can all improve each other's lives, but we're all just people at the end of the day. Don't forget your girlfriend's one of those people too.
Well, I mean, of course she's a person I love.
I take it you told her you love her.
I did.
And she said she didn't? That's why you're upset.
No, we had a lovely time.
So you're getting to know her better.
Yeah. This is gonna sound weird, but do you want to see the poem I wrote for her?
Oh my god, of course. Pretty well written.
You made it.
It's very well written. But it's a little intense since you guys just got together. But the language is vibrant and the fish metaphor is cute.
I always made it about frogs.
Why did you do that? You love frogs.
She doesn't.
Well, at least she appreciates your poetry.
You know, I'm starting to think she doesn't really like the poetry that much either.
Didn't you say you guys have everything in common?
I may have been a little hyperbolic.
Do you have anything in common?
No.
pretty much nothing. Besides the fact that we both go to this school.
So what do you guys talk about day after day?
How much we love each other.
And that's enough to keep you invested.
Love is enough. Our love is enough. Sometimes love works in strange ways. People come together for some reason, and that reason is something nobody can know.
If it makes you happy, who am I to stop you?
I am happy. And tired. I think I'm gonna go to bed.
Okay, well, I'll see you soon then. Are we still on for-
No. I'm sorry, I have to cancel. Rose and I have our 2-week anniversary.
I got
and-
it.
You do? You understand?
Perfectly.
Something seems off.
What?
Your kisses. You're using a lot less tongue.
I'm sorry. I think I'm just tired.
Of me?
No, I'm just under a lot of stress recently.
Well, I'm sorry that I'm stressing you out.
No, this isn't about you for once. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it like that. Okay, can I tell you something?
Yeah, of course.
There are things about me from a long time ago, and I'm not proud of them, and if you ever found them, you wouldn't love me again.
I'll always love you.
Thanks.
So, do you feel better now?
You know, honestly, I don't think so.
Well, what do you want me to do?
I don't know.
Is this not enough for you?
No, I just think I need some alone time.
Did I do something wrong? I did, didn't I?
No, don't stop that.
Well, you've never wanted me to just go away.
I didn't say that. Nothing is abnormal here.
Well, this sure isn't normal for you.
I think I just need to...
Wait. I'm sorry. I've been a total bitch. Let me make it up to you. We can go all the way. Right here. Right now. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
I just want to sleep.
Well, we can do that too. We can cuddle up and sleep together.
Don't wait up for me, Rose. Janine? You in there? It's been a while since I heard from you. Janine?
Wake up, Orion. We're late for our date. Come on, honey, you told me you'd take me to the aquarium. I've never been before, but you said there are a lot of fishes, which is kind of annoying because fishes freak me out a little bit, I'll be honest. They're like really slimy, and I don't understand how they work because they're like underwater, but they're breathing the whole time, right? Because you're not dead, you're not like floating there. But they swim, and they have that little like fish scale, and they just look gross. Like, I really like tuna and other fish, but I just don't like the idea of seeing them like in their homes. I don't like that at all, but you said it would be fun. And you also mentioned that there wouldn't be any penguins, but I love penguins. So I was hoping that maybe you could take me somewhere that has penguins. Why are you looking at her? Stop looking at her, look at me. She's a stranger. What could you possibly be looking at her for? I don't understand what you're seeing, but it's me. I'm the one that you should be looking at. Just, we'll go to the aquarium. And afterward, we'll get something to eat. I know I love Italian food, so we could get... Why are you looking at her? She's a stranger. Stop. She's a stranger, but I'm not. I'm the one that you should be looking at. Leave her alone and come with me. We're going to dinner. You're not even listening to me. You said that you would take me to dinner. You said that we would get dessert, and then you're looking at her, and I don't understand. Why not me? Why? What is it about me? Stop looking over at her. She's a stranger. You're not even listening to me. Did you hear anything that I said? What about dinner? Where are we going to dinner? And what about penguins? Where are the penguins? You didn't hear anything that I just said. I don't understand.
Janine, can we just talk, please?
About your girlfriend or about something other than the only subject we ever talk about?
I know. I fucked up. I spent too much time with her, and I neglected you, and I really want to give our friendship another shot. And I'm really sorry this time, so I wrote you a poem.
At what felt like the speed of light itself, a horse sprinted through the prairie, studying each and every day the hot sun, for only its rays brought him joy. The farmer beckoned to his horse each day, begging to the creature to join him at the well, and each day the horse refused to listen, instead of choosing to gallop incessantly. One day, the horse dropped to its side, parched from always refusing the water, but he found himself strength within, strength the farmer always told him he had. And with every ounce of might he had left, the horse stumbled to the well and drank, knowing the farmer was right and hoping the farmer would be there when he returned.
Sweet. Thank you, Orion. Apology accepted.
From now on, my friends are a priority.
I'm very proud of you. Besides, I haven't forgotten all the nice things you've done for me.
Speaking of which, can you keep a secret?
Sure, yeah.
I saved Harold.
Oh my god, he's so cute.
I know, I love him.
Look at his little eyes.
And that smile.
Harold is the perfect name for him.
Hey, Orion. I'm ready when you are.
What are you two doing?
Baby, 2 hours early.
You like it when I'm early.
Yeah, but this time I made plans with my friend Janine and I'm gonna stick to them.
That's not fair. I got all dressed up and... Wait, what is that?
He has a name.
And his name is Harold.
Is that a frog? Do you want to say hi? No! Ew! Come on! Look at that smile!
I hate frogs!
Was that too much?
No, I don't know how to feel about this 2-week anniversary date.
That's not good.
I'm wondering if maybe I don't like being with Rose.
What are you gonna do?
I'm thinking of considering breaking up with her.
I'm with you. Whatever you decide to do.
I'm terrified.
It's gonna be okay. You'll feel better once it's done.
Can you come with me for emotional support?
This is something you gotta do on your own.
She planned so many things for 2 weeks, and maybe I should wait, like, 1 or 2 more days.
No. That will just make things worse for both of you, okay? So, if you know that you have to break up with Rose, do it now.
You're right.
You got this, buddy.
You okay?
Yeah. Your friend just scared me with the frog.
Yeah, sorry about that.
It's okay. I'm ready to go now. I love you very much. Why aren't you saying I love you back?
Rose, I've just been doing some thinking recently, and I can't believe I'm about to say this. I'm starting to think that this relationship isn't working for me.
What?
I'm sorry.
I love you so much.
I know, and I'm so grateful.
Then why are you doing this?
I don't know. I don't know how to explain to you.
We can talk about this. When people have problems, they work through them. Why are you doing this to me?
Maybe you're right. Maybe we should talk about this.
We can pretend this never happened.
Well, okay. You know, let's take a second. We can continue this conversation once we've cleared our heads.
How'd it go?
I can't go through with this.
Turning back now is not gonna erase all the problems you told me about.
If you're unhappy with Rose, why stay with her?
It's just... when I was younger, a bunch of years ago, I made some mistakes. Some really, really big mistakes. And after spending so much time worrying about if people would find out or not, it feels like only someone who loves me as much as Rose does could possibly find it in their heart to look past what I did and forgive me.
Well, I forgive you. I mean, I don't even need to know what it was. Unless you want to tell me, but...
What?
Everyone makes mistakes, Orion. And what you did was a long time ago, so... I forgive you, and everyone else will too.
You're a good person, and I see that, and the rest of the world will too.
Then I guess it's time I forgave myself.
Can we please talk about this?
There's nothing left to say.
So you're just gonna leave me like this?
I need to end this. I don't want to. It hurts to say all of this.
It hurts to hear all of this.
Maybe we could still be friends.
After all we've done together? I don't think so.
Perhaps you're right.
So this is it then. After everything we've been through.
I guess it is. Goodbye, Rose.
Do you really think anyone's ever gonna love you as much as I do?
I do.